blurring. So is Apple a technology company or is it a media company? Is Google an IT company or is it a media company? And then, and therefore that is the, so this entire thing, and this starts from here, but I think overall, these lines are going to blur as we go forward. It's perhaps it's as of significance for all of us. It's significance for the business guys who are there. It has significance for academia, to be honest with you, because if you do, the way we go about doing things has to totally drastically change for it to be relevant to the students of the future. And just to sort of add from what Sunil was saying, while Sunil was talking about it from the point of view of science and health, I think the Internet of Things will make things easier when you come to home as well. So your refrigerator will tell you what is inside the refrigerator, not inside the refrigerator. Your laundry machine will tell you what has been washed, not been washed, and they will all talk. So I think the pace of change which is likely to happen with stuff, with things which are happening, will be something which we've not seen, and it's unprecedented. And it's, you know, as Anil started off by saying, I think analytics, particularly in our business and perhaps in all businesses, is, will drive all of this. So it's all about analytics, because that will give more and more intelligence to everything we thought was dumb in the past. And therefore that is something which is both a great opportunity, but in some ways a challenge as well. So I think as we go forward, so that's,
yeah, I just wanted to add a couple of points to this. Maybe just a quick example on the power of Internet of Things. You know, maybe that brings me back to my engineering roots in a way. So we recently worked with a mining company in the US. They're one of the largest mining companies there. And they have these big trucks that carry the ore from an open pit mine. And they have about 250 sensors embedded in each of the trucks. And the sensors send information about how much weight the truck is carrying, how fast it's moving, whether it's going uphill or downhill, the engine temperature, ambient temperature, and so on and so forth. And using that data, we have been able to change so many things that the company was doing in terms of trucks. And I'll give you one example that might be relevant to everybody here is oil change. You know, typically for oil change, and right, so you have to change the oil of your car. In US, we change it about 2,500 to 3,000 miles, maybe 5,000 kilometers or so. And that's exactly what this company was doing. You know, 1,800 hours of operation, go for an oil change. And using analytics, what we've been able to do is build a system that looks at how the truck was really being driven, how much weight it was carrying, and basically predicts the condition of the oil, and particularly the impurities that are in the oil. And based on that, is able to tell when oil should be changed. And that itself has given them cost savings about $25 to $30 million annually. And again, come based on the Internet of Data thing. The second one is another one, which is that, you know, one very important measure for mining companies is how quickly they can cycle trucks. Because the more rounds a truck can do, the better off you are. And one big challenge they face is what's called bunching up of trucks. So there will be one slow truck and every other truck will be behind it. So the question is, should I ask the first truck to go to the side and wait? Should I ask the driver to drive faster, or should I just let it go? So we have built the system which in real time calculates the cost and the benefit of each of those three decisions, is able to recommend to the scheduler, here is what you should do. So this is the person who talks to the truck drivers and informs the truck about what they should be doing. And again, by the way, we were in one particular mine, we cut the cycle time by about 30 seconds. And given the number of cycles they do and the number of trucks that they have, it's a very large cost savings they get. Another interesting thing we found out was drivers drive very well for most of the day, except for the last 45 minutes of their shift. They're all in a hurry to go home, so they're driving in a higher gear. They're going faster than what is required. And then, you know, so what now happens is about 45 minutes before the shift ends, they're given a sense that you will still finish on time, don't drive fast, we'll get you out on time. Again, you know, something that's being done through the Internet of Things. The second comment I wanted to make is that as entrepreneurs and even as professionals, I think all this change is creating tremendous amount of opportunity out there. You know, you can look at any industry, You can look at anything that is getting done right now, it will be done differently in 20 years from now. So for any of us who are looking for opportunities, these are the golden and the one of the best times to be an entrepreneur and do something out there, because change means bad thing for people who don't want to change. It is the best thing for people who want to make their change happen.
You know, it's really heartening to know about, you know, stuff which is happening in the US, investments in Internet of Things and energy, for example, you know, Musk doing his whole Tesla thing and stuff. I'm wondering, and it's a, you know, a genuine concern for me, in India, is the whole culture of this whole VC thing, investing in the next, you know, a CNF agent really, you know, Flipkart, is really a distributor. So all the guys from IITs and RECs and any of these engineering institutes, they are doing stuff which is like, you know, they're making furniture, Urban Ladder. They are guys from IITs, Lenskart, they are guys from IITs. So the real innovation, the real, you know, inventive stuff is not getting done. They're just, you know, finding the next $1 million and here is my new little shop which is just selling stuff, right? Is it killing the whole culture of innovation in the country? I mean, I think that's...
You know, I've spent 25 years in the US, so I've seen the US evolve in multiple ways. In fact, this was a question that got asked many times in the US in the year 2001 and 2002, when the internet.com way was going, because everybody was basically doing exactly the same thing, which is, you know, you're selling things, you're selling books in a physical store, let's go and sell it online. There was a company called furniture.com, pets.com, they were all doing exactly the same thing. So I think this is the first step of any innovation that happens. You know, the first level of innovation is never exploiting and using the best of the technology. It's always saying, I know a particular frame and I'm going to apply technology to that frame. It is internet 2.0 and 3.0, which is, I believe, exactly the way it will happen in India as well. The next wave of innovation and the wave of innovation after that is going to be the one that really changes the game. But you still have to go through that first step. You know, you still have to have that lens card, because without that, you will not get the sense and the understanding of doing the 2.0 and 3.0. So I don't think so. I think I'm very optimistic that these things need to happen, because that is when we will, as a country, come up with innovations that will change the world outside of India as well as in India.
Thank you so much. And this stage, there are things I'm sure all of us will get reconnected again. I'm proposing a break at this stage, come back and then continue till about 1:15. Is that okay? Thank you so much.
Hello, hello, hello. Hello.